And hello, YouTube. How's it going? Hi from Piras Motorsport and welcome back to the chat. So today I have some breaking news. First of all, I spoke with production in Italy for the airboxes. And yes, we are on time, fortunately. And if we get lucky, it appears that we could already have the finished units with the boxes and everything by the end of June. So about a week in advance of what I was thinking of. So if we are lucky, already in the real first days of June, the airboxes will be shipping out. That is great news. It took us much more time to get the bits and bobs together because I wanted them to be the highest quality and the perfect measurement and everything. So there's a lot of details on these that are actually sourced products, like the latches that close the two halves of the airbox together where the filter is, or the little balls on the bottom. I didn't want them in plastic, but I wanted them in metal, and they're all almost unfindable, the ones that bond into the chassis bracket and all of that. But now it's done and we are good to go, finally. And another good note, I have other two prototypes that are almost ready. And one is, because we were waiting for these metal parts, of course, and one is going to go at the beginning of next week to Acme Racing to do the testing and the back-to-back testing on the dynos in the final format and everything. And the other one is going to go to my friend. I promised that I would have sent out one to one of our friends and followers, and this is going to Australia to a very famous motorsports photographer that also happens to have one of the best Yaris's in Australia, that is hybrid turbo built engine and Motec. So he's also going to do mapping, and he's in a rush because he needs to get the car ready for an event. So it's going to him. And lastly, but not least, yes, you heard right in the title, we are developing the GR Corolla intake. So at first I thought, well, it's just going to fit the way it is and it's going to be fine. Very interesting. The reality is that the GR Corolla and the GR Yaris have extremely different packagings. I saw this already when we developed the three-piece hood vent kit for the GR Corolla that has already been out on the market. I've got a couple installed out there, but I'm still asking for pictures. And one of the two customers decided to only install the two side vents, so I don't like to show it because the central one is missing. But anyways, hey, it's your parts once you buy them, and it's choice, because the central really has a big impact in performance. Anyways, I saw that it was very different and we had to work a lot, and now the concept is finalized and I wish to share it with you to show you how it works. So let's have a look at this video. So here you see a full scan of the front end of the GR Corolla. So the rear part of the airbox, the one with the MAF sensor, remains the same as on the Yaris. But the front part is completely different, and it comes in two separate parts in order to go and feed fresh air into the whole system from the front of the car, because it's all different. Well, this means that we also have to build a different radiator cover, a beauty cover, as it's called. And this also has a functional effect because it makes sure that no air goes on top of the radiator instead of passing through the radiators. And another concern we had is that the third part of the ducting, that is the one that goes down in front of the radiator, may have taken away quite a bit of air from the radiator. So we are fine-tuning this part. What you're seeing now is not the final product, and we are working to make sure that we're not taking away too much air from the radiator itself. And anyways, this is the only way. I mean, I don't know how many others on the market, important brands, put out products without doing this maths and this work, because I mean, as you see, you just cannot get fresh air if you use a stopped duct or any other form of duct, because they are something like a third of the size that you need to make an engine that can go up to and over 500 horsepower. It just won't work. And the other option is to do an open air filter, like a cone filter or something, in your engine bay, but then you will not have the fresh air. Then it means that you will lose a lot of horsepower. So this is the thoughts, and this is how the product is made more in detail. And I'm loving it. I'm loving the design. It's going to be very easy to install. Once you've installed the front part that goes under the bumper, there is a bit more of a pain. Then the other two parts you can install and take off as you wish, very, very quickly, leaving the first part in place. And the first one in place should also work with the stock filter without the snorkel, and it may with the snorkel, but we're not still sure. So on this, I wanted to reach out to all of you and say that I'm looking for possibly a tuning shop or a reputable tuner in USA or Japan that is working with the GR Corollas, because I would like to cooperate with you guys and send out prototypes of these for test fitting, because I had to go to huge extents and spent a lot of money to get accurate scans of the car inside and out, without the engine, with the engine. But I don't have a physical car, neither here nor in Italy, because we just can't get our hands on it. So the math is all correct. It's all going to work, but still I want to do some fitting testing. So please reach out to me if you are a tuner and you have a GR Corolla, USA, Japan, no, Australia, of course. I'm not sure there are many there, but you know, whatever works for me. You just have to be possibly not just a private person, because I need some data when you install it, and we can work together to do this. And the time to market of this product, given that we are already stamping the GI Aris ones and we already found all these metal parts we were looking for, and all the difficult stuff is done, the time to market for this can be very, very fast. I mean, like 1 month from when we approved the design completely. So this is going to be the reference also in GR Corolla air intakes, I am sure, because There's if you look at the products on the market, you can see for yourself. Now, cutting the bullshit, guys, I'm going to be back next week. I've done great things also with them too, but I understand that on the channel, you're not so interested of hearing about the BMW. Let me know if you are, because I've got updates. I've been playing around with the chassis this week, and I've learned some valuable insights of how this specific F87 chassis works. So, as usual, if you like this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. Have a great day. Cheers.